بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى وفي الأرض آيات للموقنين وفي أنفسكم أفلا تبصرون وقال الله سبحانه وتعالى إن في اختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات لأولي الألباب وقال الله سبحانه وتعالى إن في ذلك للذكرى لأولي الألباب Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us in the Quran that indeed fil ardi upon the face of the earth are signs, signals lil muqineen for those who have certainty. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us in the alteration on the changes of the night and the day la ayat are signs for men of understanding. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala I said, in these signs, la dhikra is a reminder لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ for men of understanding. So when we see تَعَاقُبْ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ when we see the alteration of the night and the day, and we see what we see from the changes التَتَابُعْ الْفُصُولِ وَالْأَزْمَانِ the changes in season and weather and time, these are a reminder for the believers in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what is it supposed to remind us of? First and foremost, the way that one season ends and another one begins should remind all of us the inqidaa al-ajal. That our appointed time is also going to come. In the same way that the summer ended and the winter began, our time also comes to an end. It should also remind us that the way the season changes quickly, سُرْعَةُ الرَّحِيمِ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى It should remind us of how quick we're going to depart and go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The change in weather or the change of season should also remind us in the same way that we prepare for these seasons. The different weather in terms of our clothing, in terms of AC, in terms of heating. It should remind us استعدان يوم الرحيم to prepare for the day that we're going to depart this dunya. So إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ In these things are signs or remembrance for people who have understanding. So the change of seasons meant to remind us of these things. And the season we're in right now, this season of winter, how many are there for us in terms of ibra, lessons and heed in this season of winter? How many opportunities for us with ta'at, opportunities for obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or qurubat, and to get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for us in this month of winter. That this month of winter is known as mawsimul ibadat wa ta'at. Is known as the season of obedience and the season of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This season of winter, we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all times, in all seasons, but especially in this season of winter. This season is mawsimul ta'at. And very few will pay attention to this except for harisin ala kasb al hasanat, except for those who want to get hasanat and want their levels to be raised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because this season of winter is a season where the nights are long and the days they are short, and it presents a lot of opportunities for ta'at wal ibadat, for obedience and worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why in an athar, in a narration, it is said الشِّتَاءُ رَبِيعُ الْمُؤْمِنِ That the winter is the spring of the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَيْلُهُ طَوِيلٌ فَيَقُومُهُ The winter nights, they are long, so he stands in prayer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَنَهَارُهُ قَصِيرٌ فَيَصُومُهُ. And his days are short, so it takes it as opportunity to fast during this winter month. This winter month is, or season, is موسم العبادات, the season of ibadah. And Ibn Rajab rahimahullah ta'ala, he said that إِنَّمَا الشِّتَاءُ رَبِيعُ الْمُؤْمِنِ, that the only season, the proper season of the belief of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the winter. Why? He said, يَرْتَعُ فِيهِ فِي بَسَاتِينَ الطَّاعَاتِ, that the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when it comes to winter, he grazes in a pasture of ta'at, of obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَصْرَحُ فِيهِ فِي مَدَايِينَ الْعِبَادَاتِ, and he wanders in a field, or not in a field, in field of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he does acts of worship which are easy for him in this month. The same way that when it comes to the spring, تَرْتَعُ الْبَهَائِمُ, the cattle, they graze and they become healthy, they become fattened during the spring, that تُصْلِحُ أَجْسَادَهَا, it reforms and rectifies the body of the cattle, the goats and the sheep and the cows. He said, يُصْلِحُ الْمُسْلِمُ دِينَهُ فِي الشِّتَاءِ, the Muslim, he energizes himself, he rectifies himself during this winter month from acts of obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because it's easy to do so. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, الصيام في الشتاء الغنيمة الباردة, that fasting in the winter months, in a hadith in Muslim Ahmed and Tirmidhi, that fasting in the winter month is غنيمة, a booty. And a booty is something you get from war, from fighting. But he said الباردة, it's a cold booty, meaning no fighting, hardly any effort. And Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he used to call the people and he used to say to them, أَلَا أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى الْغَنِيمَ الْبَارِدَةِ, should I not show you, or should I not guide you to a booty which is cold, you don't have to fight for, you don't have to make much of an effort for? And the people say to Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, بَلَا, guide us. He used to say to them, أَسْيَامُ فِي الشِّتَى, fast during the winter months. So this month, or these seasons of winter, are the season to get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with fasting. And not only with fasting, as we said, لَيْلُهُ طَوِيلٌ, the winter nights, they are long. So a person could get so much sleep and yet wake up for qiyam and stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wake up in the last third of the night, that opportune moment that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ينزل إلى السماء الدنيا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the last third of the night, He descends to the lower heavens of the dunya. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks, مَنْ يَدْعُونِي فَأَسْتَجِيبُ لَهُ, who is calling upon me, so I'm answering. And what that means, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks, مَنْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونِي, who is seeking my forgiveness, so I may forgive him, during the last third of the night. So the nights are very long. And that's why the Salaf used to say, لَيْلُهُ طَوِيلٌ فَلَا تُقَصِّرُهُ بِمَنَامِكَ, the nights are so long, do not shorten the winter nights with your sleep. And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when winter approached, he used to say, مَرْحَبًا بِالشِّتَاءِ, welcome winter. Why? He used to say that during the winter months, تَنْزِلُ فِيهِ بَرَكَةً, that blessings that descend during these months of winter. And what are the blessings? He said the nights are long, so you could pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالنَّهَارُ قَصِيرٌ, and the days are short, you could fast for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these winter months was an opportune moment for the Salaf of this ummah. And there was nothing they regretted more than missing out on this opportunity, because they knew the values of this month. Mu'adh ibn Jabal, on his deathbed, he began to cry. And the people asked Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu, مَا يُبْكِي, what is making you cry? He said, I'm not crying for the sake of your dunya or the fact I'm leaving this world. He said, أَلَّذِي أَبْكَانِي, what is making me cry is ضَمَأُ الْهَوَاجِرُ, the thirst I used to feel, the dryness in my throat from fasting. And you know what else he said? وَقِيَامُ فِي الشِّتَاءِ, and standing up in the winter nights and praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. they knew the value of this season that we're in right now. And we should all take advantage of it. And for them, in their time, it was difficult, such as getting up from a warm bed, no air conditioning, no AC, and getting up to pray. Or making wudu, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَلَا أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى مَا يَقْرُ اللَّهُ بِهِ الْخَطَايَ وَيَرْفَعُ الدَّرَجَاتِ. Should I not guide you to something? That if you do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will erase your sins, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise your level. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِسْبَاغُ الْوُضُوءِ عِنْدَ الْمَكَارِهِ. To make wudu in times of difficulty. And one of the times of difficulty is during the winter, with cold water in the middle of the night. But yet the Salaf, rahimahumullah, azza wa jal, understanding the benefits of winter, they'll do isbal wudu, even in winter. Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to his sister, Ni'ma rajul, Hafsa radiallahu anha, what a good man Abdullah ibn Umar is. Lo kana yusalli min al-layl, only if he prayed in the night. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this hadith to Hafsa radiallahu anha, Abdullah ibn Umar was a kid. From the day the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told him this hadith, he was a child, like our children here. Abdullah ibn Umar, كَانَ لَا يَنَامُ مِنَ اللَّيْلِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. He never slept after that except for a few parts of the night. That even when he reached the old age, wherever he went, Abdullah ibn Umar would carry a jug with him to get up and make wudu in the night and pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we all need to ask ourselves, in this winter month, where it is easy to fast, how much opportunities are we taking from the Mondays and the Thursday, which is sunnah to fast? This act of ibadah or fasting that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about as so muli, that this act of ibadah is only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This act of worship, that the reward is unlimited. How many of us are taking advantage of this in the winter? Monday, Thursday, ayyam al-bayd, the white days of the month, the 13th, the 14th, and the 15th of the Islamic calendar. How many of us are taking advantage of this? How many of us have taken advantage of getting up in the middle of the night to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And this month of winter, or this season of winter, is not a selfish month whereby I only get rewards by doing that which is between me and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This month of winter is, or season of winter, pardon me, is an opportunity to get close to Allah and get rewards by remembering your brothers and your sisters that do not have the comfort of what we have. We have Muslims suffering in this month of winter in severely cold places, in tents. We should remember them in this month by giving to them in this month. This month of winter, we have people that don't have enough to eat, enough to drink in the severe cold. We should remember them. This month of winter, that from the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is clothing. We have Muslims in parts of the world, or even in our neighborhood, they don't have winter clothing. This is a form of ibadah, worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This month of winter, that we cover ourselves with our blankets. We have Muslims in many parts of the world. They don't have these things. So this month of winter, this season of winter, we should remind ourselves, وَسَارِعُوا رَيْسِ إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. It's a month of racing to forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَجَنَّةٍ and a paradise out of Doha, سَمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Which word is like that of the heavens and the earth. وَأَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين لا عدوان إلا على الظالمين والعاقبة للمتقين. Like we said about these seasons, it's a reminder for us that we're going to move on to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this season of winter, and that which we find from the coldness in winter, it should be a reminder for all of us of the akhirah. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about the Jahannam, Allah ta'ala said, all of us from the Jahannam, that he said, جَعَلَ اللَّهُ لِجَهَنَّمْ نَفَسَيْنِ نَفَسٌ فِي الشِّتَاءِ وَنَفَسٌ فِي الصَّيْفِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made two times for the Jahannam, the hellfire, to breathe out, to exhale. He said, once in winter and once in the summer. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَمَا تَجِدُونَهُ مِنْ شِدَّةِ الْبَرْدِ. What you find from severe cold in winter, min zamhariraha, is from the Zamhariyah, from the coldness of Jahannam. So the hellfire is extremely cold. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وَمَا تَجِدُونَهُ مِنْ شِدَّةِ الْحَرْبِ, and that which you find from severe heat is from the smokes or the flames or the hellfire. And that's why in the summer, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say to them, when the heat is severe, أَبْرِدُوهَا بِالصَّلَاةِ, cool it with the salah, delay the time of the dhuhr. For the severe heat is from the blowing of the Jahannam. So the winter time should remind us of the Akhirah. And when we feel this severe cold, we should follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in remembering the Akhirah and in making dua. When it became extremely cold, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, إِذَا شَدَّ الْبَرْدُ. And we should all learn this dua and teach our children this dua. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when the cold is severe, وَقَالَ الْعَبْدُ, and a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ مَا أَشَدُّ هَذَا الْبَرْدُ اللَّهُمَّ أَجِرْنِي مِنْ زَمْهَرِيرَ جَهَنَّمُ. That when it's severely cold, and the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ, what is more severe than this cold? Oh Allah, save me and rescue me from the cold, the severe cold of the Jahannam. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى لجهنم إن عبدا من عبادي استجار بي وإني أشهدك أني قد أجرته. That a slave for my slave has sought refuge in me من زمهريرك, has sought refuge in me for your زمهرير, from your severe cold. Allah Ta'ala will say this to the Jahannam, and I bear you as a witness that I've given him refuge. This is the dua the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will make when it's extremely cold. Likewise, from the things we should remember during this month or this season of winter is to remember the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Each one of us should go home and read Surah An-Nahl. This Surah An-Nahl, the Surah of the Bee, one of the names the ulama they give is Surah An-Ni'mah, the chapter of the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What Allah Ta'ala has blessed us with in terms of clothing, in terms of housing, and so on and so forth. So we increase in gratefulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this season of winter, my dear brothers and sisters, is a season of ibadat. Take opportunity of the long nights. You could sleep, get up and do qiyam. Take opportunities of the short days by fasting much in this month or this season of winter, and especially the women, because many a time we get with the women whereby due to breastfeeding, pregnancy or other issues, they delay the fast of Ramadan to the other Ramadan to make it up, or due to pregnancy. This season is a season for the sisters to use to make up their fast easily, to make up that fast, that the Ramadan should not come again and you not take an opportunity of this winter. This season of winter, we should take it as an opportunity to give in sadaqat. Because we all see, wallahi, what the Muslims are going through around the world. It is difficult and it is painful to see what the Muslims are going through. Be in India, nobody in man or humanity sees these things except it burns his heart. To see children barefooted in Syria, without cold, in a cold tent, without jacket. If we have iman in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we should be helping them. Because لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخي ما يحب لنفسه. None of you truly, truly believes until he loves for his brother what he loves for himself. We pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make all of us من الفائزين, for those who are successful and they benefit from this موسم العبادات, this season of ibadah, this season of shita. We pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he saves all of us and gives us all refuge من زمهرير جهنم, from the severe cold of Jahannam.